Welcome back to Jerry's Rastafari Dalmatian. With me, Jerry. And I've made a bunch of tweaks to the JRD Bangle Rover Mark IV now. I put a ton of parachutes at the top of this thing, which will hopefully slow it down if we have actually managed to hit Duna. I've also replaced the poodle here at the bottom of this with a couple of atomic engines strapped to some arms on the outside. I put a crap load more space tape, we reduced the amount of batteries we're carrying, and I put some solars on the rover, and I'm hopeful that we can hit Duna with this, and then once we've hit Duna, we can maybe even stop and slow down, and then maybe we can even parachute a little ways, and then maybe we can land, and then maybe we can rove, and then maybe we can come back. Not so hopeful about the coming back part, but that's not the point. Really not terribly the point. Actually, these parachutes here, I'm going to want to save in case we have to come back in this lander can. Because it's possible we will. In fact, I should put a decoupler here. Just in case we do have to take this home. Hopefully we won't have to, but we might need to. Okay. So I think we're ready to... Where did that decoupler put itself, actually? That's not where you want to be. You want to be up here. What's this guy here? I don't know. These are really weird. These ones don't really matter where they are until later. It's just the first few stages that we're going to have to worry about. I thought about possibly putting some solid boosters on this to help with the initial takeoff, but I don't think we need them. And we're just going to go with it as is. So let's see what kind of weirdness happens when I launch this thing, because it's very different than it was before. It might even explode on the launch pad. I don't know. Oh, it's nighttime. Goody. So far, so good. We got Bill on here. Which one is he in? Is he in the correct pod or the wrong pod? He is in the wrong pod. That's okay, though. We can, once we're in orbit, we can transfer him to the correct pod. For now, we're controlling from here, and that's good. And let's go with about that. And okay, good. Accelerating properly. Slowly throttle down so we don't waste too much fuel. Yeah, alright, this might work. We will see when we're back in orbit. The launch has been pretty good so far. We're going to hit our gravity turn in a minute. Not a lot of rotation either, so that's good. And hey. Nothing exploded when we turned. Excellent. And we get you here, and goodbye to you. Alright, looking good, looking good. Okay, let's see where we get. Okay, we have another bizarre orbit, but we're in orbit around Kerbin, and we have a little, not very much fuel left in this guy here. But we do still have this full thing, and then these full guys here of fuel for the atomic. And hopefully, once we've jettisoned this, we'll get so much mass back that we won't have to worry about anything ever again. Ever. Alright, now we need to go find a way to intercept with Duna. So let me go ahead and pull that up on the ksp.olex.biz. Now let's see where Duna is. Where you is, Duna? You are over there. It's gonna be a bit. Okay, not good. We're going to leave this guy here in orbit. Why don't we deploy our solars for the orbit? I will put us in a good trajectory and turn on SAS. We should be able to leave this here in orbit. And... it's not going to be a perfect... It's not actually a good orbit at all. I think we're at 92 to 140, so it's probably going to be a little off, but I think we'll be okay. Now we need to find some new thing to sit on while we wait. Can I go to something here? Let's go to the campground. That's useful. We're camping. Yay! Alright. Now, hardcore waiting. Super fast waiting. Get out your air horns. happy 2-year anniversary of our ship orbiting Kerbin, because we've been here for 2 years now and we're still not in position. Getting very close, though. Alright, that looks about good. I think we're ready to try it and see if we can get near it. Let's go ahead and switch over, not to Kerbin's turd. Nope, not Kerbin turd. Bad. Bangle Rover. Okay, and we are going to want to burn like this-ish. Hopefully there won't be any orbital bodies in the... Whoa. That doesn't look right. No, it might be right. I have to set a target there. Or an intercept. Okay, so we're trying for the old Dunanator. Whoa, I saw something. Ooh, yes, that's good. That's perfect. Well, 32 million meters is not quite perfect, but, you know, give or take a few million meters here or there. 38, and if I go this way, it is 36. So 13 million meters, that's pretty damn close, actually. We'll go for, like, something even, like, 10. Or 34. What? 19. 37. Okay, so somewhere in here is where we're going to want to be. 12. Perfect. Alright, so this is going to be a weird one. We're not going to be able to hit this right because our engine is going to cut out partway there. It doesn't know what this engine is capable of. I'm going to go with a 2-minute early burn, just off of a guess. 2 minutes seems to be a good number to me. So we'll do that. Or 140, because I missed it. So let's see if we can rotate quickly over to the right spot and accelerate. Alright, so I screwed up this burn quite a bit, but we're going to go with it and see what all we can get out of this engine. I'm really curious about how this transition over is going to be to the next couple engines, because I want to see how much thrust we can get out of our dual atomic setup and if that'll cause it to... get all funky. That seems to be working pretty okay. It's a bit funky, but manageable. We still got our solars going. But that's going to add a lot of transit time to us. Yeah, okay, so you know what? That's not bad. We're going to get there. We're going to meet our acceleration target a bit late. But the other thing to remember is that this is all the fuel we have left as far as our... stopping and then returning home goes. So really well, no, that and this, it's going to be burning through this one first and then it'll burn through the outer tanks later. That's quite a bit of fuel though. Now we hope and pray for who's this, Bill's sake. Once we're en route, I'll transfer him over, but things are looking good so far. Okay, we've got a smack into Duna encounter for about 17 million meters. We have about a half a tank left in this, and then these guys are full. And we need to move Bill from here into here, I believe. And since we're not accelerating, we should be good to go ahead and do that, although I'm a little worried. I hope he doesn't fly out. We are going 10,000 meters per second. Okay, I think we're good. Praise be to relativity! Let's, why don't we get an EVA report? High over the sun. I don't think we've had an EVA report from that before. Okay. And I think we have an antenna on here we can use to transmit that little smidgen of data. It's just a bit. Just a teeny bit of data. 40 science. All right. Yeah, we can get a couple of crew reports here. Although it doesn't appear to have the ability to transmit that data. Crew report. Okay, hold on to that. And then... I have to do it manually, apparently. Raise your data dongers. All right. not too bad. I could probably do an EVA report and get a little bit more, too. Let's do an EVA report up here. Okay, hold on to that. And we'll transmit that, too, for even more data. Data! In space, high over the sun. 26, not bad. I don't think we're going to mess with that too much more. We're just going to try to get there and hope we can slow down. Also, it appears that our countdown clock here got reset. So it's 2 years plus and almost... We're at about 2.5 years right now, almost. And it looks like we're going to get there around the 2.5 year mark for our mission. This is a very long mission. Alright, here we are very, very high over Duna. I'm going to scoot a little closer to this periapsis here, and then we will start our retro burn. Actually, we could probably do it straight from the periapsis because we're pretty slow as it is in orbit, so we've only got to slow down a bit, which is good news. We are going to have to do some pretty serious tweaks to our orbital trajectory, and I'm getting a bit of graphical vividness now. All hail the Space Kraken. I support you. Please do not eat me. Let's start it a little early, shall we? We'll get it down to about, I don't know, 500 meters per second, then we'll coast to the periapsis. Gotta admit, though, it looks pretty cool. Our spaceship. It's a spaceship. Okay, we have achieved an orbit over Duna. Unfortunately, it cost us a lot of fuel. We're almost out of fuel in this guy. We have these two left, but we're probably going to have to use them just to maneuver into a proper orbit around Duna. So, bad news bears on that regard. But, one way or another, we're here, man. So let's go ahead and get our periasshole somewhere inside of the range of Ike. Ike is 2 million meters over Duna, so we'll go for about 500,000 or so. It looks better than it is. And then we're going to have to stabilize our orbit if we can. Probably better to do the stabilization. We'll go for about 1 million meters or so. Whoa! Okay, that was Ike. Oh, Ike! Get out of my way, Ike. Oh, hey, actually, Ike can help us here. Ike will, slow us down a smidgety-widge. We'll go for 500,000. And that actually will give us a slightly better chance at stabilizing our orbit. Okay, that's about as close as we're gonna get. I was assuming we don't hit Ike. Yeah, we're going to bounce off Ike and then into a decent orbit around Duna from this. Right, so that saves us about half a million meters of burn if we do this correctly and don't hit Ike. Okay. Hello. Hi, Ike. Thank you for the braking maneuver. All right. Now, oh yeah, this will get us a nice orbit here. If I do this correct. Oh, not that way. Like this. Yeah, I'm liking this. 350 is a bit... Well, no, we're gonna need to go low anyway, so we'll go for 200,000. And then we can circularize it and stabilize it from there, but that looks really nice. Let's get it perfect. Cool. Okay, so assuming we have enough fuel to do this, we are gonna slow the fuck down. That's not quite as pretty as I'd hoped, but whatever. Okay, I completely missed my burn point, so this time we're just gonna try and slow down. And this is gonna cost us a lot of fucking fuel. Okay, we've got ourselves a nice orbit around 250,000 meters. Which is good news, but there's some bad news. The bad news is that I do not think that this is enough fuel to get us home. So, what we're going to try to do instead is use the parachutes that we brought along in an attempt to aerobrake us so that we can use all of this fuel as escape fuel, because that's our only real chance. It's a slim chance. That might not work either, but I'm like 90% sure that this won't get us home, and I'm only about 60% sure that this won't get us home. So what we'll do is we'll use this fuel to get ourselves into the range of the atmosphere, which will grab us. The atmospheric height is somewhere around 50,000, but it's so thin on this planet that I don't think it really does anything until around 5,000. So what we'll do is we'll try to slow ourselves down with what fuel we have left. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to shrink our periapsis to about, we'll go with 40,000. And then what I'd like to have happen is I'd like to go a couple rotations around and have it slow us down gradually. That would be ideal, because that means that when we do hit the atmosphere, we'd be hitting slower with a little bit more fuel to play around with. Okay, so 43,000, we'll go for exactly 40. And then we'll know quickly if this is going to work. So we're going to rotate around here, and if this shrinks when we get to that without us using any fuel, we'll know that this was atmospherically correct. Okay, so not quite there yet. Okay, we're under 60,000. It still hasn't moved that at all. So the atmosphere should be somewhere here around 50,000. And that's not doing anything. We may need to go deeper. Yeah, that's not working. Fuck. Oh, we are in the atmosphere at 40,000, and it is slightly, very slightly messing with our... Okay, so we've got a decaying orbit, but it's a very slowly decaying orbit. So I think we'll give it an assist next pass and drop it to about, like, 20,000 and see what we can get out of that. I don't want to accelerate too fast, because I don't think our parachutes have enough juice to really slow us all the way down without breaking. So, yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. That got us down to very, very slightly. Man. Okay, 20,000 is probably still going to take a few orbits. We'll see. I get the strange feeling that Bill does not like my aerobraking plan. Please, God, no. No, just send me home. We have enough fuel to go home, please. Okay, we're going to drop this down to about 15,000 this time. Now, we'll see what that does. Alright, we're already slowly decreasing our apoapsis here at 30,000. I'd like to see this shrink significantly, although we're going very fucking fast horizontally. It's not enough to slow us down significantly from this rate, but it'd be really, really nice if it was. I'm thinking maybe if we hit this thing at a strong angle at about, like, maybe 5,000 meters, it might be enough to slow us down over a long period of time that we can maybe do a slight retro burn before we deploy the chutes and then see where we go from there. I don't know. I don't know if this is going to be enough to stop us. We may need to go lower and deeper and harder and faster. Although that's actually getting... Okay, yeah, we're probably gonna stop now. Yep, we're going in. Whether this was a good plan or not, we are going in. All right, I'm going to rotate around so we're pointing towards the applesauce. Because we're still going pretty fast. Okay, how high are we? 14,000 meters? That's not good. Oh, yeah. Yep. There's no getting out of this now. Well, like I said, hopefully this horizontal trajectory will burn off most of our speed before we even get to the point where we need to deploy our parachutes. If we did a drop straight down, we probably would get in the thicker part of the atmosphere going around like 800 meters per second. Or something thereabouts. Let's use space to our advantage. Sciencing! Yeah. I'm gonna give this a bit and see, how scary things are. If it gets to about 5,000, then I'm going to start retro-burning and deploy the chutes. Okay, we've slowed down to about 500 meters per second, which is way the fuck too fast. But I'm thinking I'm going to need to do some retro-burning here because we're headed towards a mountain. And I want to slow us down as much as possible before that happens. You know, the mountain part. I'd also like to keep it a little bit slightly vertical trajectory here. because I want to get us as much horizontal and vertical breaking as we can in the atmosphere. I don't think it really thickens up till about 5,000, and we're at 6,200 at the moment. I just want to make sure we're not going to smack into a mountain before we're ready to deploy our chutes. Oh, crap. No, those are the wrong order. Not a good thing to have to do on the fly. 5,200 meters, and we're going 200 meters per second. Liking this. This is good. That's bad. Parachutes. Holy shit, it worked. Where the fuck are you going? Okay, we've got to get pointed up, and we are going to have to slow ourselves down just a smidgen with these guys, because I don't want to blow up my lander. We don't get to be picky about where we land, though. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. I think it worked. What are you doing? What is that? Oh, my crap. I think that fucking worked. Yeah, Bill thinks it worked, too. We did it. We are here on Duna in a successfully landed thing that can potentially even get us out of here. I don't know if it can or not, but we use very little fuel landing because we had the parachutes, and we've even got some extra parachutes for the trip home. Holy cow! Okay, where do you put the clean your diaper button? Where is that? I need to hit that button. That was by far the most horrifying landing I've done yet. Okay, so let's wait until day has dawned. And it appears we are on the side of a hill, near a mountain-ish thingy. What in the fuck is that? Something survived that mess? What is that? It's one of the solar panel boxes on the atomic engine portion. Managed to survive. It looks like we landed on sort of a peak of a mountain. There's something over there. I think we landed our probe over there. Yeah, we're pretty close to where we landed our probe ski, bob ski, I think. Okay, so now what we can do is deploy the lander. I am the lander commander. Alright, now let's switch over to our lander. This is it? Yes. Take them brakes off. And we gotta get this blue thing off of here before it explodes like it did on the moon. Get off me, blue thing. Don't blow up on my lander. Let's extend the antenna so that we can feel better about remotely controlling this before we actually get into it, because I don't want to put a Kerbin on that thing until it's detonated or whatever the hell it does. Get off me, bro. That one almost did it. Come on. Get the fuck out of here, man. We don't want you. You're not cool enough. Okay, now please go away from it quickly before it explodes. Alright! Looks like all of my little lander feetsies here exploded like that on impact, but the rover works. It has power and it is charging, so it has got a lifespan that is pretty good. And what do we have over here? Okay. Broken solar panels. You did your job though, buddy. Now what are you doing? Broken dancing solar panels. Okay, let's see what it's like on the surface of Duna. Look at this. Our first Kerbal on another world. Ow. He's planted in some mud. But other than that, we did it. Let's plant a fucking flag. Get him, Bill. Unfortunately, Jeb was dead during this exercise, so he didn't get to be the one. So this will be Mount Bill, mounted by Bill. Way to go, Bill. Yeah, that's fucking sweet. And I think now we can even, like, let's take an EVA report and a surface sample, and I think we can hop in the rover here and send those off. Let's see here. Herp, derp, derp, derp. Boarded. And transmit the fuck out of that data. Kerbal Space Command, this is Bill. I'm alive. Despite our commander's best attempts, I am alive. I'll send off a few of these transmissions, and then when I'm back, we can start fucking roving the crap out of this place.